let's get to the immigration crisis happening in our border, which, of course, is a crisis because there are human beings who are suffering. And that's why it's a crisis. But, of course, if you ask the media, it's not a crisis that, like, all these people want to seek asylum in the United States of America. It's a crisis that they're at the border to begin with and, you know, fucking up the place.
Pandemic-era immigration policy is officially over, and we're going to talk with the Homeland Security Secretary in a moment. But first, we're live on both sides of the border this morning. Maria Villarreal is going to start us off in El Paso. Good morning, Maria.
Hey, good morning, Michael. There were concerns and predictions that once Title 42 ended, we would see a rush of migrants at the southern border. That didn't happen here in El Paso, Texas, but what we did see was 150 migrants dropped off at the school behind me that is now being used as a shelter, the first group so far.
This morning, as Title 42 officially comes to an end, migrants amassing along the U.S. border with a surge of American authorities waiting on the other side.
We have a lot of different agencies here, as you can see. Plus, there's even more just on standby if needs be.
As of midnight, most asylum applications in the U.S. now require two things. Non-Mexican migrants must first apply for and be denied asylum in another country. And migrants will have to make an appointment on the CBP One app. If the rules aren't followed, migrants face deportation and are not allowed to enter the U.S. for at least 5 years. Overnight, a federal judge temporarily blocking part of the White House's plan to address border crossings, barring federal agencies from releasing migrants before they've been given a notice to appear in court. Amid already overcrowded facilities and millions of cases already on the court's backlog, Customs and Border Protection calling the ruling harmful, saying it will undercut our ability to efficiently process and remove migrants and risks creating dangerous conditions for Border Patrol agents and migrants. That overcrowding exacerbated in Title 42's final days. Large groups of migrants rushing to the southern border to beat the clock.
¿Cuántos días están aquí esperando?
Four days.
This family with four children waiting to get processed near the border wall in El Paso for 4 days. One of the last groups to come through before new, steeper consequences set in. U.S. Border Patrol Chief Raul Ortiz confirming already there are 26,000 people in custody. To relieve the pressure, officials flying asylum seekers to other parts of the country for processing. And overnight, an El Paso city-run shelter receiving several busloads of migrants.
And the Biden administration overnight taking another hit. The ACLU confirming they are now suing the government over what they are calling the travel ban. That is the consequence that says that you have to go through another country and be denied asylum before you could come here to the United States. George.
Okay, Maria, thanks.
Well, hey there, GMA fans. Robin Roberts here. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel.
Now we're joined now by Secretary.
Okay, so... I think I've talked about why there are people coming over the border to the United States of America many times over. People understand that at this point, you know. People are trying to escape the dire economic situation that they are that they're forced to live in many instances. A lot of those awful economic circumstances were manufactured by human beings, i.e. the United States of America. You know, that's why they're trying to come here. A lot of them are escaping rape and horrific kinds of violence. And many have valid claims for asylum seeking in the country. Of course, there are two ways to deal with this. One is the way that we're dealing with it, which is like increasing the dial of violence that these people are subjected to as we desperately dehumanize them, even though they are simply human beings just like you and I that are looking for a better alternative to their form of existence. And then there's the other way to deal with it, which is what we're not doing, which is to allow them safe passage and an opportunity to become productive members of society without constantly living in fear that the government will come and rip them away from their friends, family, and their current mode of existence once they are able to successfully cross the border and start a life here. Now, the reason why we don't do the second thing and the reason why we do the first thing is because, well, this might come as a surprise to you, but it's money. give money, do ya? Money. That's the reason why we do that, because corporations make money off of undocumented labor. They find it to be much, much more favorable to their profit margins when they're able to utilize a group of individuals that are the permanent underclass, that are not protected legally by the systems, even though the American, the I can't stop doing the Yilong Ma money thing, okay? I can't. People are not going to know where that's from, and they're going to cancel you. I mean, it doesn't even sound like I'm making a Chinese accent, so it would be hard for them to people think. It would be hard for people to think I'm doing a xenophobic accent. You know what I mean? It's like an H3 soundbite that's stuck in my fucking mind. It does. Don't down people. Okay, well, regardless, I am China's strongest, bravest warrior. Anyone who thinks I'm being xenophobic can suck my dick. There is no man on this planet that loves China as much as I do. Please don't make me play the song. Okay, let's play the song anyway, though. That's right. The real reason why the American corporations can get away with this is because you have a permanent underclass of undocumented immigrants that are escaping dire situations back home, coming to the United States of America and working for pennies on the dollar with zero legal protections, even though the American working class already doesn't have a lot of legal protections. But that's not enough for the corporations that are constantly seeking further profits and, you know, trying to find it wherever they can, specifically with labor. And that's the real reason. So having said that, knowing all of that, it's kind of a ridiculous conversation to have, the constant back and forth over this idiotic fucking situation, as we seek to justify, you know, further subjugation for these people who are, again, and I can't stress this enough, regular old people, just like you or I. People with dreams, people with children, people that want to fucking put food on the table and shelter over their and a roof over their heads. Anyway, let's continue.
Alejandro Mayorkas, Secretary of Homeland Security. Mr. Secretary, thank you for joining us this morning. Hours since Title 42 expired. What are you seeing at the border right now?
George, thanks for having me. We're seeing precisely the challenge that we expected. We knew this was going to be a difficult transition when Title 42, the public health authority that stemmed from the COVID-19 pandemic, when it ended. And indeed, it ended at 11:59 p.m. last night. And now we are using our immigration authorities, our traditional immigration authorities that deliver tougher consequences for people who cross the border illegally.
You tougher consequences, but right now you have a lot of migrants at the border, limited food, limited water. Could this have been avoided?
You know, George, this is something that we were ready for. We cannot control the movement of people before they reach our border. Our responsibility attaches once they are in our custody. I will tell you, we have made it very, very clear, and we continue.
I love liberalism, dude. I love liberalism. I love liberals so much. They're like, oh yeah, we are ending Title 42 because it was bullshit. But fear not. We're still utilizing Trump's, like, incredibly nefarious, awful white nativist immigration policy that dictates that you can't, like, touch another country on your way to the United States of America. Like, yeah, dude, people in fucking Guatemala are, like, are super fond of, like, living in Mexico when, like, people from Mexico are coming to America. You know what I mean? It's such a weird and stupid and counterproductive and racist fucking argument. Especially because it's like, yeah, dog, you're claiming that the United States of America, the wealthiest nation on the motherfucking planet in the history of the planet, does not have the resources to take care of, like, you know, a million migrants coming over the fucking border. But, like, Mexico does? Bitch, Mexicans are coming here. What the fuck do you mean? Really, dude? No, it's very obvious that it's not about who can take care of these people, and more about who we can threaten financially with tariffs, who we can threaten economically, like Mexico. That's it.
To communicate to migrants that this is not the way.
I do agree with you, but is it that simple? South American population is higher than the USA. If it becomes easy, what happens to 100 million people come suddenly? This is so fucking stupid. Okay? This is stupid. You want to know why it's stupid? It's technically easy for you to leave whatever bumfuck fucking town you live in, but yet you don't do that. Okay? Do you want to know why you don't do that? Because why the fuck do you want to leave? Also, did he say the American population is 100 million? You think 100 million people are going to come to America? Like, the only thing stopping them is that, you know, they have to do paperwork and shit and come through legally, through the legal channels? And it's not that these people aren't coming here. It's that these people are already here. There's more than 10 million, maybe approximately 20 million people that live on U.S. soil right now that simply do not have the legal paperwork and are being treated as a permanent underclass because it is very effective for businesses who want to seek higher profit margins. That's it. The entire agricultural industry in this goddamn nation runs on migrant labor that is treated like fucking shit. It is by design.
To seek relief in the United States. It's extraordinarily dangerous. They are in the hands of ruthless smugglers. We have built lawful, safe, and orderly pathways for them to come to the United States. They are going to meet tough consequences if they arrive at our border irregularly.
What is your reaction to this ruling from a federal judge last night blocking you from releasing more migrants into the U.S. without an order to show up in court?
Georgia, we consider it a very harmful ruling. The practice of releasing individuals when our Border Patrol facilities, when our Border Patrol stations are overcrowded is something that each administration has done from administration to administration. This is a harmful ruling, and the Department of Justice is considering our options.
You see, Texas Governor Greg Abbott is starting to send more buses of migrants all across the country right now. He says he's doing it because the administration is not doing its job.
George, it is a very sad and tragic day when a government official uses human beings as pawns to score political points. Objection.
And at this point, how long is the situation going to go on, and is it going to get worse before it gets better?
We have said all along that this period of transition from using a public health authority to our traditional immigration authorities is going to be tough. It's going to be challenging. But we have a plan. We've been executing on our plan. It will take time, but we have confidence that our plan will work.
Yeah, motherfucker said objection, dude. Overruled, bitch. Ace attorney-ass motherfucker, dude. Holy shit. Boys, is Phoenix right in the building? Except it's Phoenix wrong, okay? God, liberals are so fucking corny too. On top of all the other awful shit that they do, their biggest crime is being permanently corny, okay? Insanely corny. Just a bunch of fucking cornballs. Yikes.
It has worked in the past.
Secretary Marcus, thanks for your time this morning.
Thank you, George.